Would the audience please rise? As we sing O Canada, take out your bulletins, and at the back there, or in the middle there, there is the words. We will be singing two verses, and we have the words there for the second verse for those of you who don't know it.
Oh, Canada, Would you pray with me? Our Heavenly Father, may all praise and glory and honor be to your name. We welcome your presence here today. Thank you, God, that you inhabit the praises of your people. Father, we are gathered to celebrate and recognize the hard work and dedication of these men and women who are graduating today. But we also recognize that you were the one that provided the strength. You were the one that provided the call on their lives. And God, you're the one to whom deserves all the glory and honor in this occasion. And so we pray that our words and our actions, our thoughts, our motivations today and from this point on would bring honor and glory to you. It's in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Let me invite you to take your seats. My name is Rob Blackaby, and I'm honored to serve as the president of the Canadian Southern Baptist Seminary and College. We are here today as family and friends to acknowledge the extraordinary accomplishment of our graduands, but also to celebrate everything that God's accomplished in their life, and actually through their life, he's accomplished something extraordinary in our own community. And so we're doing all of that in a worship service in which we call it a commencement service, but really it's a time of worship and a celebration of God and acknowledgement. Thank you for coming. We want to thank a representative from our Canadian Southern Baptist Seminary and College Board of Trustees for being with us, DK Hale. We want to thank our national ministry leader, Jerry Tyone, for being with us to represent churches now, 370 churches from coast to coast to coast across our nation, all six time zones. And so we want to say thank you for coming.
On behalf of Ben Marshall, the outgoing chairman of the trustees, Kathy Chisholm, the outgoing assistant chairman of the trustees, our new chairman, Richard McNeil from Ontario, and the vice chairman, Terry Branscombe from New Brunswick, and the rest of the trustees. We want to congratulate the students. We also want to say thank you to all of those of you who are here today who have given of your life and your earnings to make this day possible, to have a seminary right here in Cochrane. And we also are indebted to those that have never been to a graduation service and may never be, and yet they have supported this endeavor in your life. They've invested in you, we've invested in you. And when you leave this place, you'll know that the trustees will love you. We pray for you. Remember, your allegiance is to King Jesus, but you represent this school as one of his servants. So on behalf of the trustees, would you leave this place and go forward with courage and confidence in the man named Jesus? And don't be afraid to challenge this mixed up, messed up world. You're our hope to represent Jesus Christ.
I want to bring greetings to you from the churches. Just like when someone believes, the angels all rejoice. I think on graduation day, our churches, or churches right across Canada, rejoice because there's relief coming. I guess, you know, on a day like today, we can't help but think of 80 to 90,000 people who have been displaced Fort McMurray fires. And I'm not saying this to, you know, rain on your parade today or anything else, but to say I am excited for you. I'm excited for you because you've decided to invest your life in ministry. And that means people. And so you will invest your whole life in people. And when you listen to testimonies of people who have lost all their stuff, what they really care about is their relationships, their friends, and their families. There is no higher purpose than giving hope to people when they're in crisis, when they're in their normal lives, when they're messed up. And so you have chosen a wonderful purpose and meaning for your life.
Would you stand with me as we sing All the Way My Savior Leads Me?
All the way my Savior leads me, what have I to ask beside? Can I doubt his tender mercy, who through life has been my guide? Heavenly peace, divinest comfort, here by faith in him to dwell. For I know whatever befall me, Jesus doeth all things well. For I know whatever befalls me, Jesus doeth all things well. All the way my Savior leads me, 'tis each winding path I tread, gives me grace for every trial, feeds me with the living bread. Though my weary steps may falter, and my soul athirst may be, gushing from the rock before me, lo, a spring of joy I see. Gushing from the rock before me, lo, a spring of joy I see. All the way my Savior leads me, oh, the fullness of his love. Perfect rest to me is promised in my Father's house above. When my spirit, clothed immortal, wings its flight to realms of day, this my soul through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way. This my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way.
Please be seated.
You'd open God's word to Ephesians 3. I'm going to be reading from verses 14 or 16 through 21. I pray that from his glorious unlimited resources, he will empower you with inner strength through his Spirit. Then Christ will make his home in your hearts as you trust in him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep his love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to understand fully. Then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. And that's a prayer for you graduates.
In 2012, the Faculty Achievement Recognition Award was established to honor one member of the faculty annually for his or her contribution in helping the school achieve its mission. One of the school's goals is to maintain a highly competent teaching faculty who excel in the classroom, in ministry practice, and in Christian character. In the current economic climate, it has not always been possible to hire as many full-time salaried faculty as we would like, but God continues to meet our needs with outstanding men and women in amazing ways. In 2005, then Academic Dean Bill Faulkner emailed Dr. Frankie Rainey, Professor of Christian Studies at Howard Payne University in Brownwood, Texas, to inquire about the possibility of his coming as a guest professor to our school for a semester or two. The need came about as Dr. Faulkner was resigning from the seminary and Dr. Steve Booth was stepping into the role of academic dean. The idea was that Dr. Rainey could temporarily take Dr. Booth's New Testament and Greek teaching responsibilities until he learned his new administrative position. After fulfilling his commitment to Howard Payne in the following school year, the Raineys arrived in Canada in time for fall of 2006. Today, we are recognizing the contribution of Dr. Rainey for 10 years of faithful service. Evidently, Dr. Booth was a slow learner. I need to say that the choice of the recipient of this award belongs to the real dean, not the active dean, and he also wrote the speech. So those are his words, not mine. So. But in actuality, no one could have anticipated in 2005 that by the time the Raineys arrived, Dr. Booth would have taken on the role of interim president in addition to being an academic dean. God had definitely prepared the way so that none of the coursework would miss a beat. After that initial year, Frankie and Sue had become so beloved by the whole school community that an open-ended invitation was offered to them to stay as long as they were able and as long as the Lord allowed. It should be noted that the Raineys came with very little financial support or remuneration from the school. Now, a decade later, there is a whole generation of CSBS and C students who cannot imagine what life at the school would be like without the Raineys. And the faculty and staff are having a hard time imagining such a thing as well. In addition to his wide-ranging teaching role at the college and seminary, Frankie very naturally became the campus pastor. After all, he pastored 7 different churches in Texas, totaling more than 45 years prior to coming to Canada. A steady stream of students has filled his small office ever since, seeking both his advice and prayer support. Everyone has looked forward with anticipation to his sure smile and encouraging hugs when they arrive on the campus each day. And Dr. Rainey has always been the first to his post, beginning his day with the Lord and his Greek New Testament. Off campus, he has also been a great ambassador for our school. In 2015, readers of the Cochrane Eagle voted Dr. Rainey Best Teacher of the Year, and an article in the newspaper highlighted his testimony. Additionally, Frankie has served in significant roles at a number of local churches, as well as frequently supply preaching with his beloved, Sue, always at his side. In June of 2017, they will celebrate their 60th wedding anniversary, which, by the way, is the same month when Frankie was ordained to the gospel ministry. From the very beginning of his time at our school, it has been obvious that Frankie would be a good fit. Perhaps the words of an anonymous student evaluating his first course with us will suffice. When asked how this particular course might be improved for future students, this student replied, "Keep Dr. Rainey." No, seriously, don't let him leave. This man has been a gift to our school, and unfortunately, it is now time to let him leave. But not before once more saying thank you and we love you. So is my great honor to announce that this year the Faculty Achievement Recognition Award goes to Dr. Frankie Rainey. As is typical, his award is a copy of the dean's speech and also his name engraved on a plaque that's displayed in the faculty suite. But today we also have an additional special gift that the president's going to present.
You may have a seat. This is going to take just a moment. Frankie, on behalf of our school, we want to give you a token by which you can look at, and you can remember that we love you dearly. You're welcome to open it. It's really easy.
Okay. First part was easy. Oh, wow. On the right path. Presented to Dr. Frankie Rainey, Canadian Southern Baptist Seminary College, 2006 to 2016.
I'm going to let Dr. Rainey sit down while I say what's next, because he's going to be back up here in just a moment to bring our commencement address. Let me say that when I asked him to be our commencement speaker this year, it was after consulting with Steve Booth, and we felt like, you know, here's our campus pastor. He spent a decade at our school. He shaped countless people's lives, their impressions of ministry, and what more fitting person could we have come and speak this year than our very own Dr. Frankie Rainey. It was after that that we discovered that he was going to be retiring. And so I don't want you to feel like, oh, this was a courtesy because he's retiring. We had already chosen him. And in God's wisdom, he knew it would be a part of a recognition as he retires. We also want to recognize his beautiful wife, Miss Sue Rainey. Where are you, Sue? And thank you for your years and years of service with our school. Let me tell you why we chose the sculpture we did. It wasn't one of those things that you walk in a shop and just think, oh, there's a nice one for Dr. Rainey. It's a young head of cattle, and it is called On the Right Path. There's several pieces to this for me. One of them is, after years and years of Dr. Rainey being a pastor and a professor, I think he's finally figured out God's calling, and I think you're on the right path. But also, when I was with, we gather every week with students who desire to do so in what we call a journey group. Several years ago, in a journey group, I was asked, how do you finish the Christian journey like a Dr. Rainey? And I gave them my best thoughts. And then I went and said, Dr. Rainey, what would you have said? And without pausing, this is what he said. In life, there are a million opportunities to take an off-ramp. Don't take a single one. That really has impacted me, because he's saying to you and me, as those who follow his lead, stay on the right path. I know that we follow Jesus Christ. I also know that in the model of the Apostle Paul, sometimes there are those pillars of the faith who say, follow me as I follow Christ. I feel like that's been Dr. Rainey. We're accustomed, as sad as it is, to in moments like this release our graduates and say, this is why you came, was for this day, and we knew that this leaving would happen. But it's not necessarily the same thing with faculty. You hold on as long as you can. And when the day does finally come, it is with great sadness, but also in anticipation as to the next chapter, to say, we now release you to what God has planned for you next. And so you're on the right path. After Kathy brings our special music, I am honored to introduce Dr. Frankie Rainey as our commencement.
Well, graduates, it is the start of a new journey for you all. And whenever I get asked to bring special, I try and find a song that not only impacts me, but that will speak to you. So as you go on your path forward, wherever God takes you, if he doesn't answer the way your prayers the way that you want him to, trust in him. When he takes you along a path that you're not sure of, trust in him. He's there. Letting go of every single dream, I lay each moment at your feet. Every moment of my wandering never changes what you see. I've tried to win this war, I confess. My hands are weary, I need your rest. Mighty warrior, king of the fight, no matter what I face, you're by my side. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers as I cry out to you, I will trust in you. Truth is, you know what tomorrow brings. There's not a day ahead you have not seen. So in all things be my life and breath. I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers as I cry out to you, I will trust in you.
Dr. Blackaby, the decision has been made. Sue and I are taking Kathy with us. Last night after the festivities were over, I was thinking I should give a disclaimer right now, because just about everything I intended to say today was said last night by the testimonies or by Dr. Blackaby. And what was not said last night just got through being said by Kathy's remarks and beautiful, beautiful song. But I feel morally obligated to go ahead and give it to you anyway. So Dr. Blackaby, trustees, colleagues, platform guests, family and friends of those who are graduating, I'm greatly honored to address the graduating class of 2016. And you're welcome to listen in as to what I'm going to say to them. I've tried to calculate how many commencement services I've been a part of through the years. This is my 10th one here at CSBS&C. When I was at Howard Payne University as a professor, I participated in 17. I've been a part of commencement services five times when I was graduating. I've been through services for children, spouses, grandchildren, spouses, friends through the years. So I have no idea how many I've attended. And I have no idea who the speaker was or what the subject was of the best I ever heard. But I do remember it was the shortest. Therefore, I intend to be brief. So let me say, dear graduating students, I can never thank God enough for the privilege of getting to know you and having an opportunity to speak into your lives. You've been a great joy, so thank you. Thank you for being you. I commend you for your hard work and your perseverance and congratulate you on your achievements. When Dr. Blackaby asked if I would be the speaker this year, I began immediately to think of departing speeches, last words. So I thought, I wonder what would happen if I just looked at a number of individuals in the scripture and looked at some of their last words and see if there might be some words for you who are about to graduate. And I want you to know I found a gold mine. Now, what I want to do is hit the highlights, but I hope that some of you will take these same passages and others and develop a sermon series or maybe a Bible study series. I'll start with Moses. There was no farewell speech as such attached to these words from Deuteronomy 34:9, but this is what the scripture says. Now Joshua, the son of Nun, was filled with the spirit of wisdom, for Moses had laid his hands on him. The first thing I want to challenge you to do is to pursue wisdom. You have a great deal of knowledge, but knowledge without wisdom, among other things, can lead to intellectual snobbery. Wisdom will enable you to apply the knowledge correctly. Joshua is famous for these words, "Choose for yourselves whom you will serve." I want to apply it this way. Nail down your commitment to Jesus as Lord of your life. Affirm that confession regularly. Take your stand with him and say, "I am not looking back." Even if Jesus turns out to be a fraud, which he will not, of course, let your witness be, "I'm going down with him." Why? Well, there'll be times when you'll face disappointment and discouragement. At times you'll feel like a failure. You'll face criticism. And let me just say at this point, don't fight back. Listen to your critics. Try to see things from their perspective. Learn from them. But turn to Jesus and say, once again, "You're Lord of this situation. I cannot handle it properly, so once again, I surrender to you." There'll be times when you simply do not know what to do. again, turn to Jesus and say, "You are Lord over this situation. Show me what I should do." In 1 Samuel 12, verse 1 and following, Samuel's farewell address is recorded. In the process, he asks this question: "What fault have you found in me or my leadership?" Here's my challenge: be a person of integrity. No matter where you go or what you do, your life should always be the same. So let your life be such that it'll be the same at home as it is when you're in public ministry. Let your life be such that it'll be the same whether you're at home, at the grocery store, at the gas pump, or in public ministry. Be genuine. Be a person of integrity. These words of Samuel are found in 1 Samuel 12, 23. "Far be it from me that I should sin against the Lord by ceasing to pray for you." You are already, or you will be, at least partially responsible for the spiritual care of a group of people. What I want to challenge you to do is to develop a plan for praying regularly for those for whom you're responsible. When I was a pastor, I prayed through the church membership every Thursday and Friday mornings in my intercessory prayer time. I would start with the people whose names began with A and pray as long as I could for the time allowed, and then put it away for the next day and then the next week. Quite often, as I was praying for a specific family, I had a nudge inside to follow up. And almost invariably, when I did, I discovered that there was a challenge on the other end that I didn't know about and no one else knew about. I've continued that practice as a professor. Every Thursday morning when I have my intercessory prayer time, I pray for all of you, all of our current students. We're small enough that we can do that. So when I know about your families, their names, and so forth, I pray very specifically for each one of you. And also pray for a group of our graduates every week. Keep a list of where I had to stop the week before, and then I start up again alphabetically. So if you're not already, become an intercessor. It's work that's done in private, and often you will not know how God is using your prayers. But occasionally, he will give you the privilege of hearing from someone, and you realize that God was working their lives at the same time you were praying for them. David's last words to Solomon, his successor, recorded in 1 Kings 2. Here are some of those words from the first three verses. When David's time to die drew near, he commanded Solomon his son, saying, "I'm about to go the way of all the earth. Be strong and show yourself a man, and keep the charge of the Lord your God, walking in his ways, keeping his statutes, his commandments, his rules, his testimonies, as it is written in the law of Moses, that you may prosper in all you do and wherever you turn." I would put it this way for you: take personal ownership of your life and your faith. Take responsibility for your actions, your decisions. If things do not go the way you hope, don't blame others. If you realize you've offended someone, or you become aware that someone thinks you've offended them, take the initiative, ask their forgiveness, and be restored. Develop your own personal walk of faith. Have your heroes, your mentors, but allow the Lord to develop you into the person He created you to be. There's a niche in the kingdom of heaven that only you can fill, no one else can. And if you're trying to be someone else, it will not work. In many ways, Paul's second letter to Timothy that we have in our New Testament is his farewell speech. Here are some of his words. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead. Remember Jesus, students. Cry out his name. Worship his name. Bow before his name. Remember Jesus. He also says later, preach the word, I would say, and teach the word. Be ready, in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with complete patience and teaching. Minister the word. Do it when you feel like it, and do it when you don't. Do it when it's well received and when it's ignored. When it's convenient and when it's not. When it's popular and when it's not. Minister the word. God has promised that his word will do its work. He has said that his word will not return to him empty, but it will accomplish the purpose for which it was sent out. I became convinced as a preaching pastor years ago that one of my primary responsibilities was to enable God's people to read or to hear the word of God clearly. Because I knew that once the word took root, the word would do its work. Some of Paul's last words are particularly intriguing. He knows his days are numbered. But he says to Timothy, bring the scrolls, and above all, the parchments. He wants to be in the scriptures. You might say he's done it all and can coast the rest of the way, especially since he knows that the time of his death is near. However, he wants to spend time in God's word. So graduating students, get into the word until the word gets in you. Read it, memorize it, meditate upon it. Be a lifelong student of the word of God. Finally, let's look at a few of the last words of Jesus. In John 20:19 and again in 21, he says the same words. In 21, it adds a few words. Here are the words that are found in both verses. Peace be with you. Peace is that deep, settled, inward rest, knowing that no matter what, all is well. Jesus has given you that peace. You will need it when the storms come, when people disappoint you, when you're betrayed, when some of your dear friends die, when you have no more strength left. Receive his peace. Then he adds these words, as the Father has sent me, even so I'm sending you. And when he said this, he breathed on them and said, receive Holy Spirit. You know your assignment. You're to make disciples. Or as we've been wonderfully instructed in recent years, you're to make disciple makers. You cannot do that in your own strength. You must be empowered and equipped by the Holy Spirit. You cannot live the Christian life apart from the Holy Spirit. You cannot offer godly counsel without the Spirit. You cannot bear the challenges and difficulties apart from the Spirit. So follow Paul's advice in Ephesians 5:18. Be filled with the Spirit. And now let me leave you with these words from Paul from 1 Thessalonians 5, 23-24. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. And may your entire spirit and soul and body be found blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful. He will surely do it. Amen.
Thank you so much, Dr. Rainey, for your words, your example, your life. Now, graduands, we've come to that moment that some of you have been playing over in your imagination for quite a while now, some of you for a very long time. It's very likely that what has kept you going on more than a few long, dark nights of the soul was the anticipation of walking across this stage on a Saturday afternoon, shaking Dr. Blackaby's hand and holding a piece of paper in your hand that says that you've passed the last test, you've written the last assignment, you've read the last book, you've learned the last lesson, you've had a dream, and the dream was to be able to say today, I'm done. The journey's over, it's finished. We may as well go ahead and say it. Dr. Rainey's already said it. The truth is, you're not done. The journey's not over, it's not finished. And we hope that if you've learned anything through these years with us, it is that your learning is a lifelong endeavor. You have acquired some knowledge, you've picked up some tools, you've charted a trajectory, but we pray that this is not the end of your learning, nor is it even the beginning of your ministry. You were following after Jesus and serving God when you came to us. You've been following after Jesus and serving God while you've been with us. And today, as you leave us, you are following after Jesus and serving God now as well. It's neither the end nor the beginning, but it is a milestone worth celebrating. The diploma you received today represents the fruit of your efforts. It means that because of your sacrifices and your diligence through these years, you now present to God a mind that is more knowledgeable, a heart that is more pliable, hands that are more skillful, and lips that are more ready to proclaim the gospel as good news to a world that so desperately needs to hear good news. This is indeed worth celebrating. So bask in this moment. Rejoice in the accomplishment, and know that you do not rejoice alone. Your teachers rejoice with you, with hearts that are both sad and happy to see you go. Sad because your lives have become so intertwined with ours that this transition in our relationship is painful even to think about, and we will miss you dearly. Happy because the very reason we do what we do is not just to take you in, but to send you out. It's not just to receive you, but to commission you for the ministry to which God has called each of you. And as you look around in this room, you'll see many more who rejoice with you as well. friends who've encouraged you, parents who have believed in you and supported you, brothers and sisters who have prayed for you, children who have sacrificed, spouses who have shared the dream as well as the burden. We all stand together with you celebrating your accomplishment and rejoicing in God's grace. We acknowledge his work in you. We anticipate his work through you, and we affirm his calling upon your lives. And so I'd like to invite all of you, our honored guests, to join in a tradition that we have in our commencement services. We ask that when the name of your graduate is called, that you reverently stand while they cross the stage in honor of their accomplishment. There will be a moment to celebrate each one after they've received their diploma with thunderous applause. But if there is anyone in your group who wants to slip out into the aisle and snap a few pictures, that's perfectly acceptable. Our photographers will be busy at work as well, but feel free to personalize this day for your special graduate. Now, just before we formally confer the degrees, we'd like to recognize one student who has completed a non-degree instructional program this year. The Certificate of Christian Studies is a one-year program designed for students who want to deepen their understanding of God's Word, practice the principles of spiritual growth, and mature in their ability to discern and follow God's direction for their lives. Their courses are taken for academic credit alongside those students enrolled in degree programs. This year, one student has completed the academic requirements for the Certificate of Christian Studies. Would he please approach the platform to receive his certificate? Receiving the Certificate of Christian Studies is Kevin Higgins. Wish Kevin God's richest blessings as he continues to follow Christ wherever he leads. And now for the conferring of the degrees. Will the graduands please stand? All of you, yes. Upon recommendation of the faculty and as authorized by the Board of Trustees, it is my pleasure to certify that these 14 graduands have met the requirements and the obligations of their respective academic programs and are therefore entitled to receive the appropriate degree as lasting evidence of this significant achievement. Please now take your seats and the attending faculty take your positions, please. The graduates can be seated. The Diploma of Christian Ministry is a two-year, full-time undergraduate program designed to equip church leaders and other Christian ministers with the necessary tools to serve Christ effectively. We have one graduate receiving this diploma today. Would this graduate please stand and approach the platform? Brianne Nicole Ryan, Diploma of Christian Ministry.
Brianne, Brianne was born in London, Ontario, but has lived in Cochrane for the past 16 years. During her time at CSBS&C, she served as children's ministry intern at Bow Valley Baptist Church and for the past year as children's ministry coordinator at Pathway Church. She says she has grown in her personal relationship with God during these 3 years and has become a better student and public speaker. Brianne feels blessed to be graduating and thanks her professors, her teachers, her friends, her boyfriend, and her family for supporting her during this great learning opportunity.
The Bachelor of Christian Ministry is a 3-year full-time undergraduate program oriented towards ministry preparation for those who sense a call vocationally or also for lay leaders. Would these 3 graduates please stand and approach the platform? Russell James Falk, Bachelor of Christian Ministry with distinction.
Russell was born and raised in Manitoba, but now calls Calgary his home. While working on his degree in the college, he has served as a young adult leader, youth ministry leader, prayer team leader, fill-in preacher, and children's Sunday school teacher at South Calgary Community Church. Russ has made the Dean's List every semester and was honored this year with the Delta Epsilon Chi Honor Society Award for outstanding academic achievement and exemplary Christian character. He has also served our community well on the Student Council. Russ's plans are to continue his studies at the master's level in our seminary next fall, as well as to learn something about parenthood as he and Nicole welcome their first child into the family in August.
Sebastian Gunther, Bachelor of Christian Ministry.
Sebastian grew up in southern Manitoba and has also spent a good part of his adult life in Saskatoon. While working on his BC Min degree, Sebastian has served on the worship team at Tapestry Church, where he has also been the leader of the prayer ministry for the past year and a half. During these years, Sebastian has also started 4 blogs as in the process of writing a novel. Upon graduation, he plans to move back to Saskatoon and use what he has learned in future writing endeavors. Sebastian sums up his feelings about graduation simply, "I'm glad to be done."
Leslie Aaron Lentz, Bachelor of Christian Ministry.
Leslie is a native of Napanee, Indiana. She has managed to complete her degree in spite of a bout with shingles, 5 kidney stones, 4 kidney stents, and 1 major kidney surgery. Leslie has served as vice president and president of the Student Council, student services assistant, and as children's ministry leader at Tapestry Church. She is excited to see what God has in store as she and her family return to Indiana. Leslie says, "To be walking across this stage at the age of 32 feels amazing. I wouldn't be here today without God, my family, and this amazing school. Thank you for all who have encouraged me and prayed for me throughout the last 4 years."
The Master of Christian Studies is a 2-year graduate level program designed for those seeking more theological grounding, whether in a ministry setting or as a Christian layman or woman in any profession. Would these graduates please stand and approach the platform? Shauna Mae Dolan, Master of Christian Studies.
Shauna and her family came to faith here in Cochrane 6 years ago. During the course of that time, Shauna was led to pursue Christian ministry and, as a seminary student, has served on various worship teams, has authored and published 2 books on faith matters, and has been used by God to further kingdom interests in areas as near as the First Nations community in Morley and as far as the Maritime Provinces. This year, she received the Evangelism Award. In the months to come, Shauna anticipates further opportunities to simply do what she loves best, that is learning the will of God, living the will of God, and inspiring others to do so more boldly.
Jeffrey Clyde Elias Way, Master of Christian Studies.
Jeff was born in St. John's, Newfoundland, and has moved to Calgary in 1988 as a general surgeon at Rocky View Hospital and chief of trauma. It was here that he met his future wife, Marianne Manning, whom he married in 1989. The Waves have three daughters, Jillian, Emily, and Sarah, who are all present to celebrate with him today. Jeff took his first course at CSBS online in 2003 with the intention of enriching his own personal Bible study. The degree he receives today is the fruit of 12 years of steady effort in the midst of a busy medical career. Along the way, he has found his seminary training to be invaluable in many situations on a number of medical missionary trips that he and Marianne have made together. He now hopes to put his theological training to use in the area of medical ethics as he currently sits on a province-wide expert panel regarding physician-assisted death.
The Master of Biblical Studies is a two-year graduate-level program designed to equip students with skills for in-depth study and interpretation of the Bible. Would the two graduates who have completed this degree please stand and approach the platform? John Myron Logie, Master of Biblical Studies with distinction.
John and his family came to Cochrane from Bonnyville, Alberta. During his time here, he has served as interim pastor at Nanton Baptist Church, in addition to practicing medicine during the summer breaks. John will be working in Stettler, Alberta this summer while looking for longer-term work and ministry opportunities. He looks forward to being used by God in bivocational ministry, whether pastoring, teaching, or discipling, while practicing medicine. I am very thankful for my time at the seminary in order to prepare for the rest of my life, John says. There has been a definite imprint on my life that I will take with me wherever God takes our family.
Helen Haysuk Park, Master of Biblical Studies with distinction.
Helen was born in Seoul, Korea, but now calls Calgary home. When she came to the seminary after her retirement 7 years ago, she just wanted to know more about God and never expected to finish a degree. Yet here she is today receiving her Master of Biblical Studies. A passionate disciple maker, Helen received the Evangelism Award in 2014 and plans to continue her work through the discipleship ministry of Center Street Church. She is especially excited about this new phase in her life as she becomes a grandmother very soon. She is grateful for the impact of the professors and staff and for the sacrificial support of her family. Helen says, "I thank God with all my heart for giving me the opportunity to learn, the availability to continue, and the ability to finish."
The two-year Master of Christian Ministry degree is designed to prepare students for competent Christian leadership in a wide variety of ministry callings. This year, we have one graduate who has completed the pastoral leadership track of this degree. Would this graduate please stand and approach the platform? David James Lee Hansen, Master of Christian Ministry with distinction.
David is a native of Edmonton, Alberta. During his seminary years, he has made the dean's list every semester, discovered a passion for young adult ministry through his service as leader of the Bowness Missional Community of Tapestry Church, and most importantly, found Amy, the love of his life, with whom he is now engaged and planning a September wedding. In addition to this, David's future plans include serving the church with an emphasis on young adult ministry and discipleship. "My time in CSBS has been transformational," David says. "The friends I have made and the community I was part of have greatly impacted my values and beliefs. It has been a pleasure growing together with others."
The Master of Divinity is the most widely recognized degree designed to prepare Christian leaders for the church and many other settings. It is a 3-year full-time study program and covers a range of biblical, theological, missional, and practical ministry disciplines. The program also includes a hands-on ministry component, along with a focus on spiritual and character formation. Would these 5 graduands please stand and approach the platform? Emily Mary Buck, Master of Divinity with distinction.
Emily is from Leesville, Louisiana, and came to CSBS after serving a term as a missionary journeyman in East Asia. While here, she has helped to plant the Springbank Chinese Baptist Church in Calgary, helping particularly in the areas of children's ministry, finance, prayer, and ESL. She has also been the administrative assistant for church planting at the Canadian National Baptist Convention. She was this year's recipient of the Cunningham Christian Service Award. Emily has been accepted into the PhD program of Fuller Seminary in California, where she will be studying church history in the fall.
Hansung Kim, Master of Divinity.
Hansung came to CSBS from his native South Korea. During his years in seminary, he began his ministry with young adults at the Calgary Korean Baptist Church. He is the recipient of this year's Lifeway Pastoral Leadership Award. His plans upon graduation are to continue to focus on young adult ministry in his church. Hansung says, "I really appreciate the seminary because they helped me to be equipped with very healthy biblical knowledge and godly character as a pastor."
For expected summer completion, Daniel Jonathan Kazmaier, Master of Divinity.
A native of Calgary, Dan has been active in many ministries while in the seminary, including leading an Arabic youth group, serving on the missions team at his church, and helping to start Canadian Global Response. He also served our seminary family by working in the development office at CSBSNC. However, he considers his most important achievement to be receiving the Mr. Award, Mary and Connie in an outdoor wedding on the hill last summer. After graduation, Dan plans to continue learning to be a husband and working in media at CGR. Apart from the incredible professors and friends, Dan says what he'll miss most about CSBS is Free Food Thursdays.
And for expected summer completion, Leona Papineau, Master of Divinity.
Leona came to Cochrane from Durowville, Alberta, in the Peace River Country. While working on her degree, she has served as children's pastor at Emmanuel Church in Calgary. She has also been a great encourager, especially to many of the young single students on campus who have enjoyed many happy evenings together in her home. After graduation, Leona plans to live in Calgary, continue in her ministry at Emmanuel, and leading summer camps, spend time helping her daughter Ariana to fulfill her dreams and goals and be a servant for the Lord in whatever capacity he sees fit. Her final word to the seminary community, thank you.
Daniel David Spellacy, Master of Divinity with distinction.
Daniel came to CSBS from Saskatchewan. He has served in youth ministry during all of his seminary years, first at South Calgary Community Church and then at Bow Valley Baptist Church. He has made the Dean's List every semester and was the recipient of both the Randall Harper Preaching Award and the Blackaby Spiritual Leadership Award. He plans to continue his ministry at Bow Valley for at least another year and is excited to see where the Lord leads him and Kayla to serve in the future. Daniel sums up the hearts of all our graduates when he says, I am so thankful that God not only has our end destination planned, but also the path we need to take to get us there.
Now would all of our graduates please rise? Ladies and gentlemen, I am privileged to present to you the 2016 graduates of Canadian Southern Baptist Seminary and College.
Would you stand with me and with the graduates? We'll sing How Deep the Father's Love for Us.
I invite you to join the graduates and the seminary family at the president's reception immediately following the service, right outside of the sanctuary, up the stairs, and into the fellowship hall. Now let us pray. Dear Lord, we ask for your blessing and guidance as we celebrate your goodness. For these graduates, we look ahead with anticipation and nervousness to a future that is sometimes uncertain and always unknown. We pray that you would bless and guide these graduates today. We ask not that you would prosper their plans and schemes, but looking to you for guidance and direction and strength, that they would follow wherever the wind of your Spirit might lead them. May you bring forth in them the unmistakable fruits of love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness and faithfulness and gentleness and self-control. And blown by the wind of your Spirit, may they go out into this world loving you, loving your word, and loving the people that you loved enough to give your own Son to set them free. May you use them to build your kingdom here on this earth, even as it is in heaven. For it is in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen.